Hello, myself Shivangi Lohomi. I'm a legal intern at LEXIS AND COMPANY. I'm from Yashwant Rao Chavan Law College, Pune, Maharashtra. Today my topic is kidnapping. Kidnapping means taking away a person against his or her will by force, threat or deceit. Usually the purpose of kidnapping is to get a ransom or for some political or other purposes. Kidnapping is classified into two categories in section 359 of IPC and defined in section 360 and 361 of IPC. Let's understand these sections better. As per section 359 of IPC, kidnapping is of two types: kidnapping from India and kidnapping from lawful guardianship. These two types are explained in section 360 and 361. Let's look into them in detail. Kidnapping from India. Section 360 explains kidnapping from India. According to section 360, if any person takes a person beyond the limits of India against the consent of that person or against the consent of someone who is legally entitled to give consent on that person's behalf, then the offense of kidnapping from India is committed. Illustration: A is a woman living in New Delhi. B takes A to Bangladesh without her consent. B committed the offense of kidnapping A from India. Now, kidnapping from lawful guardian. Section 361 explains kidnapping from lawful guardianship. According to this section, if a person takes away or entices a minor, a boy under age of 16 years and a girl under age of 18 years, or a person of unsound mind away from his or her lawful guardian without the guardian's consent, then that person commits the offense of kidnapping from lawful guardianship. Thus, the essentials of kidnapping from lawful guardianship are: illustration A is a boy of 13 years of age living under the lawful guardianship of his mother, Z. B convinces him to accompany him to his house against the consent of his mother. According to section 361, B has committed the offense of kidnapping from lawful guardianship. Here the minor is A. The lawful guardian is his mother, Z, and the person who is committing the offense is B, as he is taking A away from Z against Z's consent. This section also mentions an exception. It says that it does not result in the same in the crime of kidnapping from lawful guardianship if the person in good faith, that is honestly with reason, believes that he is entitled to the lawful custody of the child or he is the father of an illegitimate child. Hence, if in the above illustration B believes that A is his illegitimate son, then his act of convincing him to come to his house without his mother's consent would not result in kidnapping from lawful guardianship. Age of minor. Section 361 of IPC clearly states that minor is a male under the age of 16 years, a female under the age of 18 years. However, it must be highlighted here that in Manipur, the age of 18 years of females in section 361 is replaced with 15 years. Hence, if a female of 16 years is taken from lawful guardians in Manipur, it would not result in kidnapping from lawful guardianship. Taking and enticing. Section 361 mentions whoever takes or entices a minor away from his or her guardian against the guardian's will is punishable with the offense of kidnapping from lawful guardianship. Punishment for kidnapping. Section 363 of the IPC lays down the punishment for both kinds of kidnapping: kidnapping from India and kidnapping for lawful guardianship. Punishment prescribed in the section is imprisonment of either description, which can extend up to 7 years, and fine. Imprisonment of either term means either of two imprisonments prescribed in the IPC. Simple imprisonment. This means that during the imprisonment, the prisoner is idle and is not required to do any hard labor. Rigorous imprisonment. This means that during the imprisonment, the prisoner must engage in hard labor. So this video doesn't solicit any types of promotion or advertisements as per the guidelines of Bar Council of India, and the sole purpose of this video is for education purposes only. Please like, share and comment on my video and do subscribe this channel. Thank you so much.